Choosing editing dimensions for a video can be a little tricky, especially if you don't know or need a specific size. That's why Camtasia sets them for you based on your recording area. If you record a custom region, the canvas size will match your recording dimensions. If you record full screen, Camtasia will default to an automatic size, maximum 720p HD. 720p refers to the canvas height, which means the video will be precisely 720 pixels tall. Camtasia will scale the width based on the dimensions of your recording. If you're not sure where or how people will be viewing your video, I suggest sticking with these dimensions. 720p is a versatile standard that's comfortably viewed on large monitors, laptops, and tablets. It's also okay for mobile phones. Just make sure you zoom in whenever reading small text is important. For more on zooming and video quality, you should really check out this tutorial. If you do know where people will be watching your video, you can optimize your dimensions for that output. To open the Adjust Canvas dialog, click the Canvas Zoom dropdown and select Adjust Canvas. The preset dropdown contains a list of commonly used dimensions. If you're sharing to a video hosting site like YouTube, I recommend going with 1280 by 720. Or if you know people are going to be watching the video on a specific device, like an iPad, choose from this category. If you don't find what you're looking for in the dropdown, you can always enter custom dimensions. If it's important that the new size maintains the proportion of your recording, make sure this box is checked. Then, enter a width and a height. When you're finished, click Apply. You may now need to adjust the recording to fit the new canvas size. Just click and drag the corner handles until everything looks the way you want it to. If parts of the canvas are still visible and you want to change the background color, go to the Canvas Zoom dropdown, select Adjust Canvas, and click the color circle. There are a few ways you can select a color. You can choose one of the pre-selected colors, create a new color using the hue slider and palette, match a color from your recording, or enter custom RGB or hex values here. For the most part, I like to use black or white because bright, saturated colors can be distracting. When you're done, click Apply. Now, anytime the canvas is visible, you'll see the new color. Well, that wraps up this tutorial, but if you have any questions, let us know at feedback.techsmith.com. Thanks for watching.